Hi, I'm Samir, and now we'll learn a trick to find the square root of a perfect square quickly.
Let us begin by taking 21904 as an example. The first step would be to split the number, keeping the last two digits aside. So we'll get 219 in the first part and 04 in the second. We observe that 219 lies between 196, which is 14 square, and 225, which is 15 square. The answer would be in two parts. The first part will get the number whose square is smaller, which in our case is 14. The second part is a bit tricky to obtain. I would want you to concentrate on the table given below for a moment. It shows a mapping of unit digits of numbers and the unit digits of their corresponding squares. Now, we can observe that if a square ends in 1, then the number would have either 1 or 9 as its unit digit. Similarly, if a square ends in 4, then we have either 2 or 8. If 9, then 3 or 7. And if 6, then it would be 4 or 6. In our case, the square ends in 4. So the number can have either 2 or 8 as its unit digit. Now, since 219 is closer to 225, we'll take the larger of the two choices, which in our case is 8. So we can write down our final answer as 148. Please note, had the number been closer to the smaller square, 196, then we would have chosen the smaller of the two choices, 2 instead of 8. We'll see that in next example. Now let's take 20164. Here again, we'll split the number, keeping the last two digits aside. So we'll get 201 in the first part and 64 in the second. We observe that 201 is also in between 196, which is 14 square, and 225, which is 15 square. The first part will get the number whose square is smaller, which in our case is 14. For the second part, our choice could be 2 or 8. In this case, 201 is closer to 196. So we'll get 2 in the second part. Finally, clubbing these two, we'll get our final answer as 142.
I'll again emphasize that this trick can be used only when the given number is known to be a perfect square. If not, you will arrive at an incorrect answer.
Let us try to elucidate it a bit further by taking 76176 as an example. The first step would be to split the number, keeping the last two digits aside. So we'll get 761 in the first part and 76 in the second. We observe that 761 lies between 729, which is 27 square, and 784, which is 28 square. The answer would be in two parts. The first part will get the number whose square is smaller, which in our case is 27. Now we move to the second part. Here the square ends in 6, so the number can have either 4 or 6 as its unit digit. Since 761 is closer to 784, we'll take the larger of the two choices, which in our case is 6. Now clubbing these two, we can write down our final answer as 276. Let us take another example, 75076. Here again, we'll split the number, keeping the last two digits aside. So we'll get 750 in the first part and 76 in the second. We observe that 750 is also in between 729, which is 27 square, and 784, which is 28 square. So the first part will get the number whose square is smaller, which in our case is 27. For the second part, again our choice could be 4 or 6. In this case, 750 is closer to 729. So we'll get 4 in the second part. Finally, clubbing these two, we'll get our final answer as 274.
Thanks for watching. See you soon.